What's up, everyone? Welcome back to Cloak the Grandmaster. In the last episode, we beat our best opponent yet, a 5.5k Zerg, and it wasn't even close. I think it's a sign that we're evolving. Cloak the Grandmaster might now be at its peak. We also crossed our own peak MMR. We are standing at 5,048. Let's get higher. All right, the first game of the day is against a Terran player. That name is very familiar. We've definitely played against that guy before. Now, he is a Terran, which has been kind of the bane of our existence over here at Cloak the Grandmaster, so that's always going to be a little scary. Now, I have an important question for you guys, okay? So recently, not quite sure if, you know, most of you have noticed, I was doing a couple polls in the community tab in YouTube about what my next Zerg and Protoss challenges should be, right? But I also want to know what my next Terran challenge should be. Not that new. My MMR is already very, very high, well into Grandmaster. But the reason why I didn't do a poll for Terran units is because I am kind of out of ideas at this point. I have done so many Terran challenges already that it's, you know, what units do I even do? At some point, I was thinking about doing SCV pull to Grandmaster or so. So I want to ask you guys for some suggestions. What should my next Terran challenge be? If there's like a bunch of, you know, good suggestions, I could make another poll in my community tab and see how it goes, see what option comes out. I always feel like this is a little awkward. Am I on YouTube? I'm like, I'm trying to talk to everyone here, to him, to you guys, to myself. All right, let's decide on the strategy before we go further. But yeah, I really hope you guys come up with some good suggestions. I know you guys are a smart bunch, so I'm sure it'll be all right. Now, he knows it's me, obviously. One thing that confuses me a little bit here is that he clearly knows the name, but he did ask me if it was a new series. So I kind of think maybe he was just trying to chat me up a little bit. And he is aware of the series. Like, first I wanted to say, okay, so he's asking me what, you know, if he's on YouTube. So he's not aware of what series we're doing. But it is pretty suspicious, right, guys? You have to admit. It's definitely pretty suspicious. I'm going to wall off the front. Maybe he was just trying to distract me or something. Obviously not going to play too scared or anything. But we got to keep, you know, our options open. Gonna do a normally timed SCV scout. And yeah, I think we should just go back to what we've been doing for a while, which is to focus more on ghosts than banshees. Now, I do have to be a little scared here because there could be a second barracks. I think in that case, we would still be able to defend. Recently, I've been feeling safer anyway, making my expansion on the high ground rather than on the low ground. Now, I could send this Reaper across the map to try and get a scout up. This is incredibly risky, by the way. In TVT, sending your first Reaper across the map, like, I know it sounds like something very small, but it's really risky. Losing the first Reaper across the map could mean that you just lose the game. So you need to be... Oh, I did forget to cut out of gas. I guess I'll cut an extra SCV then. You do need to be very, very on top of things. Let's see if I can get this Reaper. Okay, not the best grenade by him so far. Can I get... Oh, I almost got that hit off. You guys saw that? My Reaper was about to shoot. So let's see. I think I'll make one... No, I'm going to make the command center first, actually. I was going to say, I think I'll make one Widowmine first, but a command center right away makes more sense, I think. Especially because it's on the high ground. Don't necessarily need to worry about defending it as much. Going to spread my depots around as much as I can. Just for vision. You know, not any deeper reason than that. You know, I actually had a couple ideas over time that I never got to do. That in TVZ late game in particular... No expansion yet, by the way. Very scary. TVZ late game in particular. I thought it would be very smart to just cover all of this with your depots. Like, just make all of your depots there. So you can't get Nidus. Because, like, getting Nidus is actually very painful. Oh, that's a really good mine. Let's go. That's one Reaper dead instantly. Very, very nice. We are clearly getting cheesed of some sort. I don't really know what it is, to be honest. But something is going on here. Okay, so he went for 1-1-1 double tech lab. He's not... Okay, I was going to say, why is he not locking on there? Might as well. There's a Cyclone as well. I'm not quite sure what we are to expect here. I mean, it looks like he's going to be attacking us early. But it's also kind of hard to say with what he is attacking us exactly. I'm going to make a bunker at the front. If it's just Cyclones, then we're going to be pretty good anyway. These are the Marines. They're just going to be guarding that ramp for... You know, maybe even a good couple minutes. He has at least one Reaper left, so obviously I don't want to leave before I get the Reaper. He has a Starport as well. The Starport was making a Tekla, by the way. That's very important to notice. Yeah, the weird part here is it's not necessarily that weird, but it's just that he expanded super late after a 1-1-1. But it's also not like... Wait, I killed something. Could have been a... Guys, that could have been a Cyclone, actually. I really didn't see. That could have been a Cyclone. That would have been like the biggest dub ever. But yeah, he doesn't have the add-ons to go for a proper one base all in. But he is on, you know, he is very, very long on one base. So I'm not quite sure what to expect here. And I think I'm going to spread this one over here. But one thing that I do think... it could be Banshees. Banshees would be terrifying. Yeah, okay. I was thinking it was going to be Raven first. But Banshees is definitely scarier. Banshees don't really have a counter this early on. Maybe I should... Yeah, I'm going to hide them in the mineral line like this. There we go. That's kind of smart. I'm going to make an engineering bay as well. Because their economy is obviously going to be pretty good. Wait, he lost something else to that as well. I think, yeah, I'm not quite sure if I killed a Reaper or a Cyclone, but both of those would be pretty good, to be honest. So, here we go. I'm just going to repair that. It's not really going to do any damage. Could be Battlecruisers too, of course. If it's Battlecruisers, then we definitely know that he's aware of who we are. It's only better that I might as well just jump out. Yeah, exactly. Even better that I'm going to go for an engineering bay, because we'll have to make turrets. Yeah, if it's Battlecruisers, we are going to be in a big amount of trouble, but at the same time, he's not paying attention. Ooh, that took so much damage. At the same time, his economy is not that great. So maybe I'm just going to scan. Maybe my Banshees can pop off. Okay, so he's just playing hyper defensive. Okay, very interesting. Should I be going across with these Widow Mines perhaps? Then I think maybe it's not a crazy idea. Oh, well, I was going to say, oh no, we got caught. But I think he was the one that was caught. So I don't think we have to worry about that. I do need a third command center at some point. I think I'll just build it down instead of making Widow Mines. And then I'm going to go into Ghost. I mean, my opponent is barely playing super, super defensive. So I don't necessarily have to, rush any kind of attack or something like this. It is pretty hard to play against defensive Terrans, of course, as we have seen before. Gonna start spreading these Widow Mines a little closer to his base. Maybe we can get a nice spread. That is okay, dude. I didn't even see that Marine. I was like, where the hell did that come from? Is that a Banshee or something? Or like, I generally couldn't tell at first. Okay, so I'm gonna go for double engineering bay right away, I think. Gonna start spamming ghosts like crazy. I have three Banshees now. Let's see what a setup is like. Yeah, okay. This it's gonna be a way different game than normal, because I think I need to play greedy rather than like smart. I don't even know how to call it. Like, normally I go for the outplays and stuff like that, but here I really think we're in a situation where I'm the one that has to play greedy. So we killed those Widow Mines are actually popping off, by the way. Like, I killed another Marine with those. Maybe I can bait him into that Widow Mine too and kill another one. I mean, I know it doesn't sound like a huge deal, but if you over time, if you kill, 20 Marines by just using those, it's actually going to be pretty good. Okay, let's start getting a little ghost up. Maybe I can run that. Oh, wait, that means he's not here. So maybe I can kill the gases. He doesn't have gas yet. Okay, that's also pretty suspicious. I was scouting the corner of the maps because I was feeling a little suspicious already. Let's see. Yeah, this looks like... Oh my god, that's a bunch of... Oh, I'm going to kill the Cyclone too. Here we go. I was going to say a bunch of tanks going to die, but I guess we'll just kill two tanks and the Cyclone. He's going to drop auto turrets as well. That's kind of surprising. Wait, no. I was going to say my speed finished just in time that I was going to escape with all of them, but I barely did it. That would have been freaking beautiful if I did. So he's going to go for a massive... Well, yeah, it's not really a two-base all-in because he has a third CC, but it seems like it's kind of like a low eco, like super hard attack. So what I'm going to do is build turrets around my base, and then I'm going to start going for nukes. This I'm actually going to make a planetary. Planetary is normally not the best against Terran, actually, because tanks just kind of kill them over time, and then you're like, yeah, the planetary is at a better economy all this time. I'm gonna make an armory as well. Let's see. I need to spread my Widow Mines a little better. I have a couple available, I believe. Yeah, just to make sure he's not moving out of his base for free. That killed another Marine, probably. The Marines look kind of damaged, but it's also pretty hard to say if they were already damaged, right? Okay, so now he sees that I have this base. Let me just burrow all of these in the middle of the map. My economy is looking pretty good. If he moves out, by the way, I know he has multiple turrets. But I can totally kill this turret in the mineral line really fast. Banshee DPS is not crazy, though. So if he repairs instantly, we might be in trouble. Okay, so now he's going to start taking that. I'll send my, my one nuke, basically, to the top. Like, look how much damage that Banshee took. It's actually pretty crazy, right? Okay, so he's going to try to kill the red one, obviously. Not going to allow that to happen. There you go. All these Marines are dead. He could be attacking us, I suppose, because I don't see anything. Okay, there he is. I mean, I killed the gas, which is pretty nice. It's also not massive. But here, it's going to be a good distraction for my ghost. Let's see. I'm just going to nuke that instantly. He does only one... Wait, he doesn't have a turret here out of all the plays. Okay, that's pretty funny. Okay, like, he probably has... Now also, oh my goodness, he left this, that's crazy. He left his entire main base open. Yes, okay, I'm actually slightly annoyed because I, judging by, wait, what did this kill? 10 kills on that ghost. Ouch. You know, because of the turrets here, I kind of just figured that everything was covered, right? Oh, no. Guys, I'm afraid that he has kind of messed this up a little bit here. I have the Banshee. He's going to have to micro these super well. Or these Marines super well to against these Banshees. Else he's just in a massive amount of trouble. Oh, I need to repair that. Actually, I think I'm a little late on that already, right? Yeah. Not the biggest deal ever, but oh, that Widow Mine couldn't quite get a shot off. That's unfortunate. I am gonna have... I think I have... Wait, do I have a nuke? I don't have a nuke, right? No, I don't. Okay, his army's pretty massive. I was gonna say it looks bad for him. Let me cloak that real quick. Okay, thank goodness. I was gonna say it looks bad for him, but I guess he just has such a big amount of Marines that I can't really attack either of his sides. That's the biggest problem. Gonna try to take the base on top as well. Is he gonna move forward? He is slowly gonna move forward. Let me try to repair these Banshees. It is funny how freaking difficult it is every single time to play against freaking... Like, doesn't even matter, like, how good the early game is for me. Like, these freaking TVTs, man. They're so hard. It's actually crazy. He also somehow dodged all of my freaking Widow Mines. Let me just EMP that Raven. There we go. Get fricked. Okay, I'm gonna send one of these ghosts up here. That's gonna drop a nuke. Actually, I could nuke him from two sides, perhaps. Let's see, this one nuke could maybe come from up here. And then the other one could be like slightly behind over there. There we go. A double nuke gonna be going up. Let me saturate these gases at the same time. So he's probably gonna check for the... Wait, he's not moving, guys. He's getting absolutely sandwiched by two nukes. Look at this. Oh, both tanks are gonna go down. And he had to run away. That's beautiful. Now I can get in there again. And I have an EMP. Guys, there's no energy on those Ravens. And my army's pretty massive here, honestly. You know, that tank died instantly. I can burrow the mines. I don't think I really have to. And there we go. The mines might get a shot off. Oh my god, the Vikings get destroyed too. And that was actually a beautiful defense somehow. The double nuke killing two of the tanks. Very, very nice. Now, I do need to build the nukes again. The nukes are so instrumental to my success. Oh my god, he is insane. He's actually insane for landing those Vikings. Oh my goodness. Probably going to kill at least two of those. Here we go. His army's pretty big. Wait, I have one too. I made armor instead of attack first. That is very interesting. That is not a habit at all. I guess I must have not had the money when I started my attack upgrade and had it when I got armor. Wait, guys, this is not... That's not a big army, you know. I would obliterate this, actually. Look, I also have the... Oh my god, the cloak advantage. Look at this. He's getting absolutely dusted here. Absolutely beautiful. Let me kill the Marines too. I know he has an army, so I need to be careful. Good. Oh, that Widow Mine can pop off. Barely not gonna pop off, unfortunately. I have another Widow Mine here too. I wonder if I'm being too risky here, but I would love getting some free trades. Let's see. Okay. Using the range of the ghost. Okay, now he's gonna go for it. That's what I expected. Let's see if the Widow Mine can pop off. Okay, Widow Mine, there we go. Oh, really good amount of damage here. I don't have the Widow Mines to back this off, though. It would have been really nice if I had, like, just a couple more Widow Mines there. Okay, so I have two nukes available. That means I'm going to... Actually, the third nuke is going to build fast enough anyway. I'll send two to the bottom, and then I'll send one more to the top, trying to get a nice triple nuke off. I mean, my supply is looking very healthy. He doesn't have a lot of Vikings anymore, so maybe I could use that. I do want to be really careful with these. Maybe I should get drilling claws at some point, but I guess it just doesn't feel that useful when they have, you know, so many freaking Marines. Okay, let's see. So I'm going to go for a surround nuke. That's the plan. We're going to go for a surround nuke. Here we go. Oh, I don't have the third one yet. It's almost going to finish, I bet. Yeah, it is almost going to finish. There we go. The double nuke. He's going to see one of those. Okay, so he sees this one. The other one goes up uncontested, though. Here we go. We're going to kill something. Oh no! He didn't expect the second nick. That is absolutely brutal. 14 minutes in. I mean, I was definitely ahead of this game anyway, but oh my goodness, that nick was... It was his entire army, guys. It's just all gone. Oh man, poor guy. He knew it was on YouTube as well. The moment he saw that, he could imagine my reaction probably. Oh my god, that is absolutely disgusting. I mean, I have a lot of ghosts here. Ghosts are pretty... Oh, the Widow Mines didn't have high ground vision. Slight oversight by me. This fight, I'm definitely going to win with the ghost. There we go. Widow Mines also proving very useful. Guess I'll launch some nukes, mostly for the follow-up. Like, I don't necessarily need these to win the fight. But if he tries to get a little bit closer, let me EMP that for good measure. Wait, if he runs away, the nuke is going to kill the SUVs. Guys, the nuke is actually going to... No, not again. Oh my god. Oh my god. god, those nukes were so beautiful. Dude, I have 108 SUVs, 16 ghosts. He has 44 SUVs, 1 marauder, and 7 debris. Like, even these last two nukes are beautiful. Check this. He wants to repair the command center. But then this nuke comes in, his army comes in at the same time. Look at this. Most of it dies, and then the second nuke finishes that off. Oh my god, I'm running out of breath here because this was freaking crazy. What a game, guys. 5k ahead in units lost. More beautiful nukes. Cloakdirk and Master absolutely peaking right now. Let's go to game number two.
Right, game number two against the Protoss player. Now, I definitely don't think we're going to have nukes as good as in that last game because that was just absolutely incredible. Now, I do have to say, guys, I've been having a fantastic time cheesing these Protoss player with cloaked units. Like, it's just such a vibe, you know? Wait, I have another cheese in mind. Okay, let's do a crazy cheese here. I feel like I've been doing a lot of lifting the factory into the main making. Just Widow Mines there, pretty much. But on this map, you can't do it. But I wonder if I could go for... What I'm thinking of is going for reactor factory. So I make a barracks, make a factory, then make a reactor on the barracks and switch them over and get like super fast reactor widow mines rallied into the base. I feel like this is one of those strategies that's either freaking amazing or the worst thing I've ever seen. You know, which does fit some of the strategy choices I've made before. Now, let's see. So I could either go in with like two, right? Or I could wait for a bunch. Like, the thing with two is... I'm just gonna paint for you guys what I have in my head, right? Let's say two widow mines, la la la. They... No, I wasn't trying to make it into a children's song, but... let's say there's like a couple of depths waiting here. Maybe I'll get to the ramp before I have to burrow. From that point on, all the next widow mines are gonna get blocked, right? Like, I won't necessarily be able to walk into his base anymore. If I go with six, I could probably reach all the way into the mineral line. And then I have that position forever until he gets detection, right? Now, obviously, if they go for like a fast target or fast robo, that might be negated. I don't know. It kind of sounds like a pretty cool strategy to me. So I think I'm going to make one Marine. It's very normal to make a Reaper here too, but I just want to make the reactor a little faster. And Reapers take a freaking... If you guys didn't know, Reapers take an eternity to build. Like, it is 32 seconds compared to 18. Reapers take way longer to build than like Hellions even, for example. Like, it's pretty crazy. Now, I do think I can cut some gas. I mean, I only need to make an armory and a reactor, which is like 150 gas, so I don't... Well, I could also go for the proxy starport after for a battle. Okay, this is just getting dumber by the minute. I'm going to tell you guys one thing that I'm afraid of here, and that is that my opponent... Excuse me. Is going for a cheese himself, because we have not been scouted whatsoever. And you would think that I should be happy with that, but it's also a little bit discomforting, maybe, you know? Like, I feel like there could be just like a... this is a crazy SCP path for me to take, by the way. There could be like a gateway, like, right here. I don't know, a freaking robo or something, you know? And I would have no idea. I could even... Should I fly my barracks into his base? I can't believe all the stuff I'm coming up with right now. Let's see, where's the starport going to be? The starport's going to be on this side, of course. Guess I can start saturating this gas. You know what? I think four is a good number. The main... I would actually fly the barracks into his base for like perfect scouting. The reason why I'm not doing it yet is because he hasn't scouted me. So he doesn't even know that we have something on the map. I always think, by the way, I don't think it's ever happened before. But I swear, one of these games, we're going to run into a player that's just AFK. You know, like, we've been, like, talking about the mind games and the intricacies and stuff. And then the guy is just straight up not there. I mean, at this point, I wouldn't even be surprised. Because where's the stuff? I haven't seen anything. Like, where is just, like, anything at all? Let's see. Does he have his natural, at least? What if he's doing the proxy carrier build? Okay, so there's an adept here. He went for a blind battery. Okay, this is great. Here we go. The four widow mine squad walking into the base. Okay, so he has one Phoenix. I need to burrow this at the perfect time. Did I get it? Barely. Oh, that was so close. Barely didn't get it. Okay, so my opponent is going for Phoenixes. I'm going to make a factory. Yeah, I know it's absolutely absurd. But yeah, I mean, I guess that's just the point where... You know where we're at in the game right now. I'm gonna burrow this a little further away. This one is going to go on top of the ramp. I guess we can slowly just sneak forward. Oh, I targeted the Adept. There we go. I actually got target on the Adept. That is crazy. Like, I'm making Widowmines way faster than he is making Phoenixes, right? Like, I can make them so freaking fast. I do think there's an Oracle. You can see the little logo there. There is an Oracle being produced. Okay, so I'm going to put this one over there. And then this one is going to go even further. I'm going to try to start snooping these Widowmines forward. So, am I going to kill Phoenix? We got a freaking Phoenix. Oh, my goodness, guys. I think I have too much stuff for the oracles to detect. Oh, he does have a robo already. I'm going to burrow one here. Guys, this is going to be crazy. No, I thought I got it. The observer finished at the perfect time. He is going to lose another adept to it, though. And now I'm going to get in here. Let's see if I can... Oh, this could be a massive hit. Guys, this could be the biggest hit ever. Oh, my goodness. No, the oracle activated at the last second. Oh, my God. This is so freaking close. I'm getting this over here so I can get drilling claws as well, by the way. Now I have another squad of Widowmines. Is it time to move those up already? I mean, he does have Pulsar Beam. I'm going to start getting Drilling Claws here. I'm only going to make two Banshees, by the way. I'm not going to make any more than that. Okay, so I'm going to put this one over here. Dude, I swear, we are so close to killing the freaking Oracles. Well, my opponent's probably like, what the hell is going on here? Like, this is so absurd. Yeah, oh, okay. Oh, we killed the Observer, I think. Yeah, we got the Observer with the splash damage. This is so good. I can't believe we got the freaking Observer. He does have another lift. Let's see. Oh, that almost shot as well. Now, maybe now I should go for an expansion. God, this is so freaking crazy. Like how my barracks is just chilling here as well. I mean, I am going to get two Banshees. These Banshees are definitely going to be less effective. Oh, I didn't make that. Definitely going to be less effective because of the Observers, though. Maybe I should be... Yeah, I'm going to run the Widowmines in first, I think. Look how much Widowmine production I have, by the way. Like, it's actually pretty crazy how much Widowmine production there is. Okay, so here we go. The Banshees are going to go in now. He does have a couple gateways. Here we go. I mean, he's going to kill these really fast, so I need to target as many probes as I can. I'm probably going to get at least 10. We're on 7 already, I believe. There's 8. Oh, he does have a Revelation, too. Probably a faster way for him to kill them. Okay, I think we got about 14. I think 14 is a pretty accurate estimate. Oh, I didn't burrow those yet. Maybe I should be backing off for a little bit because he's just killing these Widowmines. Yeah, just too fast right now, right? I'm going to start hiding some around the map here. I mean, I do have an expansion. We're not exactly in a lovely spot, though, I have to admit. Maybe I should go for two more Banshees because they have been proving very valuable here. I'm going to start rallying some. Maybe I could just burrow them everywhere. So when he ever moves his Phoenix across the map, we can just take them down real quick. He does have a robo. I feel like we've been in this scenario before where the robo is scary for the late game. Because if he ever gets like Colossus or Disruptors out, then, you know, what are my Widowmines really going to do? Oh, I lost the barrack, so I can't even make an orbital. I mean, this might be one of the first situations ever where I don't think I need an orbital. I guess I'll make the barracks anyway. Yeah, I suppose I can make a reactor for it for my next factory. Oh, here we go. Yes. Oh, almost got both of them. That would have been massive. Wait, he was not paying attention. Oh, I'm trying to bait him a little bit. Yeah, he got bait. No, yes. That's a double kill. I'm pretty sure both of them died. Okay, that is so freaking brutal, guys. I think both of the Phoenixes died. Okay, he does have a pretty massive army, I have to say, guys. His army is looking really, really big here. Wait, maybe I can bait him. Is he going to come back for this? I feel like he might. Let's see. Is he going to come? Oh, guys, imagine if he comes back there. Oh, we got so many probes. Please go back. Just go ahead and defend your base. You know you want to. Okay, let me make the factory after that. Oh, dude, I didn't even realize. Obviously, I need a barracks to make a factory. That's so funny. I thought I was just going to get it for the orbital. Let's see. Can we get some shots of the observer? Is a little bit too close, I think. Or too far away, rather. Now, I could make a planetary here as well. Let's see. Wait, if he didn't realize this, guys. Here we go. Yeah, he didn't realize. Look at these Widowmines. They're going to pop off. Oh, my goodness. That is so many Stalkers going down. Absolutely beautiful. And now I got multiple factories building. Guys, this game has been freaking insane. I think we are probably still in a lot of trouble. But I don't know, guys. I mean, there's definitely a little opportunity here, right? I'm going to send those across. I need something to defend. That is my main concern, really. Okay, I'm just going to go here. Guess I'll just burrow them one by one just to be a little annoying. There we go. Might be able to get a couple Stalkers here. If he's not paying attention, I could get a bunch. I think all of those died, right? Because there's... Oh, one of them is going to survive, I suppose. Okay, so this Banshee is kind of going to pop off here. That Stalker is going to fall as well. We're doing so much freaking damage here. Is it time for me to start making Ghost, perhaps? I guess it would be a good idea. I'm going to make that a planetary now. I think what I should do is just burrow in the mineral line kind of thing. Because, like, I know he has the cannon. Wait, maybe I can depower that? Probably not. I know he has the cannon, but realistically... Oh, my ghost plan is kind of ruined now. I can probably kill a lot of these workers. Well, I can definitely depower the first cannon. That's maybe not the craziest idea. Okay, I'm going to bring these back. I mean, the planetary is going to get up at some point. Okay, so he recalled. Let's see. Probably, is it to the other nexus? It might have been to the other nexus. Okay, here we go. I'm going to surround all of his workers. Oh my god, this is going to be so massive. Watch this shot over here. It's going to be big. Yeah. Oh my goodness. Everything died pretty much. He doesn't really have workers left. The planetary is kind of popping off as well at the same time. Oh, he sieged the prism. Can I reach that? I think I can barely reach it, right? No, just one more. Oh, it's actually not in range. Can you guys believe that? Okay, I'm just going to surround him with Widow Mines at this point. If I can kill the prism, that's going to be it. I made a Hellion. I guess that's going to be a nice decoration. Okay, the prism is going to go down, and that means all of these units are going to follow as well. There we go. He has a couple units remaining, but they're not... Okay, let's just make sure I don't kill him with the Hellion. We have beaten the Protoss player. And oh my god, this game was freaking crazy. I think that's the third time in just a couple days that people do the spam pause. He had 3 probes left. I killed 57 probes once again. This was a really high over Protoss player. I think it was 5k as well. And oh my god, this game, like last video and this video, the games are freaking insane. Like the Xerxes episode, this cloaked episode, the games are just crazy. And guys, I'm just freaking tired. Like these games have been too epic. I know normally I like to play 3, but today I'm going to leave it at 2. Like this episode is just a masterpiece that I don't want to alter anymore. Hope you guys had a fantastic day and just like I did. Make sure to get a video, like, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see y'all for the next one. Adios.